50 years ago today, Apollo 11 lifted off into outer space and a few days later landed on the moon and into the history books. Now, decades later, this monumental mission is still inspiring people of all generations. CBS 2's Vanessa Murdoch has more.
3, 2, 1, liftoff on Apollo 11.
From the long walk to the Saturn V to stepping foot on the moon, the Apollo 11 mission captivated Americans and curated hope.
To me, Apollo was more than a mission. It was a mindset of hope that exploration can live forever.
I spoke with NASA's Jim Garvin via satellite. He was just a young boy when three men set out to do the impossible.
We were cheering like someone had won a Super Bowl.
50 years later, Americans are celebrating all over again. Students from the Intrepid Museum's Goals for Girls STEM program heard from former astronaut Timothy Kopra.
And I hope that you all can find some inspiration from what these heroes, my heroes, and what these pioneers did.
It's kind of surreal, actually, because if you think about it, these are the pioneers that kind of led in space exploration. Without them, we wouldn't be where we are today.
From the moon to Mars and a manned space station in between.
So much wonder and amazement in NASA's discoveries and accomplishments thus far. But I want to know what's next.
We're at the cusp of a new exciting phase with the Gateway and Artemis program. You know, we're looking to put into space another station that will be in an orbit around the moon. Much more exciting things lie ahead for humanity.
So I'm hoping in the next 20, 30 years, we will have human presence on Mars as we learn from that sustained presence on the moon. That's my dream.
Before then, NASA plans to send the first woman to walk on the moon. That mission, Artemis, slated for 2024, is already inspiring young minds.
That's really cool that like we're taking a step forward in like women and women's rights and like taking a part in all these events.
So you're hoping to be maybe the second woman on the moon.
Yeah, maybe.
For certain, celebrating this moment in history with such gusto is inspiring our future. From the Intrepid, Vanessa Murdoch, CBS 2 News.
And on Saturday, the American Museum of Natural History will be holding an event called Space Fest, where you can watch a recreation of the landing in the Hayden Planetarium. Pardon. The New York Hall of Science will also host a party Saturday night. All kinds of stuff going on, including on your television tonight. Join CBS Evening News anchor Nora O'Donnell for the CBS News special, Man on the Moon. It will include parts of the broadcast from Walter Cronkite, that historic day, and narration from the late Neil Armstrong, the man first to step on the moon.